นะฮะอันนี้ชิ้นประดับคือตรงนั้นสิ่งเช่นนั้นผมก็ยังไอ้ครับดูดีในมือดีสั่นเอาแรงก็ดีดีสั่นคอมพิวเตอร์ของเราเป็นเด็กฟาดเดิมเทนนิสโคซิดานิสันฟารินอาสันอเมริกาวิสต้าบิคาร์ปอร์ตวิสต์ในเดือนสัปดาห์นี้สัปดาห์นี้สิครับสิฟาดเดวิลิมันดีกี้ so อันท็อปิกพูดอะไรบ้างที่ผมสั่งให้คุณยูนิสเกี่ยวกับเดือนฟอร์ตวิสต์ and I would like to reflect with youthe importance of this year, not only for us priests, but most especially for you, our people, God's people. And on June 19 of 2009, actually the Pope expressed his concern for priests on March 16, 2009, before the Sacred Congregation for the Clergy. Ito po yung isang unang opisina that attends to the needs of the clergy. And in that meeting with the Sacred Congregation for the Clergy, the Pope said that he will declare June 19, 2009 as the start of the year for priests. Ngayon, tatanong ko po sa inyo, what is it that we celebrated last June 19, 2009. That's the solemnity of the Sacred Heart. No? So if you recall, if you remember, John Paul II dedicated the Feast of the Sacred Heart as the day of prayer for the sanctification of priests. So remember that up to this point, our Holy Father Pope Benedict has declared the solemnity of the Sacred Heart as the day of prayer for priests. Ito lang po yung katangi-tanging araw na inilalaan para po sa panalangin sa mga pari. And soon, this year for priests will end on June 19, 2010 of this year, gathering as much as possible many priests in Rome. Actually, even our priests here in the Archdiocese of Manila are already preparing for this gathering, no? Because the Holy Father wanted to see all priests throughout the world. Of course, not everybody can go to Rome for that occasion, but majority of the priests in the Archdiocese and in the dioceses here in the Philippines will be going to Rome to join the meeting of priests with our Holy Father, Pope Benedict XVI. So, tatanungin niyo po, why the need for a special year for priests? Bakit kinakailangan po ng isang taon na inilalaan para po sa mga pari? Well, first, it is because we commemorate this year the 150th death anniversary of St. John Mary Vianney. Alam ko po, lahat po tayo alam natin si St. John Mary Vianney. St. John Mary Vianney is the parish priest of Ars in France. No? And in this celebration, the Holy Father declared John Mary Vianney not only as the patron saint of parish priests, but as the patron saint of all priests, which means now, not only the diocesan priest, but even the religious priest. So, there are two types of priests, diocesan and religious. Now, we have St. John Mary Vianney as our patron saint. And what's the objective? The first objective is to deepen the commitment of all priests to the call to holiness, what we call interior renewal of the heart. And secondly, to rediscover and revive the awareness of this extraordinary gift that God has given not only to the priest, but most especially to all of you, our dear people. I hope that you see in us the gift of God, that we are God's gift to you. and that this is the time for us to become aware of that and to become grateful for the gift of priesthood. And the theme taken by Pope Benedict is faithfulness of Christ, faithfulness of priests. But this year also, the CBCP, our Catholic bishops, also declared a special year, which is the year of the two hearts, the year of the Sacred Heart, and the year of the Immaculate Heart of Mary. But what is the intention of our bishops? First, they recognize that there is a crisis in our country, and that is what we call moral crisis. And so, there is a need for us to undergo some kind of renewal as a nation. And then, it is also a time for us to make an offering, an oblation of ourselves again to God. And then, it is also a call for us to conversion and to consecration. And then, it is a call for us to put into our hearts the values of the kingdom of God. But is there a contradiction between the year for priests and the year of the two hearts? What do you think? Is there a contradiction? Kung ating titignan, St. John Mary Delay has an answer to that question. There is no contradiction. Because for St. John Mary Delay, he said, the priesthood is the love of the heart of Jesus. The priesthood is the love of the heart of Jesus. Kung meron pong unang-unang minamahal ang puso ni Jesus, ito yung walang iba kundi ang kanyang mga pari. And we know whatever is the love of the heart of Jesus, it is also the love of the heart of Mary. And we hope that it is also your love. No? We may not be your first love, but we hope that you love us, your priests. Now, I would like to point to you a question, and you need to answer this question. Do you know that you are priests? Alam niyo po ba na kayo po ay pari? No? Do you know that you are priests? I think many of you whispered, yes. Yes. By what virtue? By virtue of your baptism. By virtue of the gift of baptism that we receive. We have become priests by virtue of our baptism. And this kind of priesthood is what we call common priesthood. Ibig sabihin, yung pangkalahatan. We are part of that common priesthood. We are still part of your common priesthood. Because we will never be priests unless we receive the gift of baptism. Now, most of us have attended baptism, and one of the beautiful lines that we hear during baptism is when the priest anoints the forehead of the child, he says, as Christ was anointed priest, prophet, and king, so may he live always as members of his body, sharing everlasting life. And in that sense that we all share in that priesthood of Jesus. Now, perhaps you wonder, why is it that there is a need to ordain men to become priests? If we are all priests, why the need to ordain men to become priests? I think through the holy orders, what we call the holy orders, there is another participation in the priesthood of Christ. So first, we receive what we call common priesthood as the gift that we receive at baptism. But the moment a person is ordained a priest, he receives another participation in the priesthood of Jesus, and that is what we call ministerial priesthood. Now we see the distinction that there is what we call common priesthood and the ministerial priesthood. But What is the difference? Where is the difference? It differs in essence, no? It differs in essence. By virtue of baptism, we receive the common priesthood. But by virtue of ordination, we receive the common priesthood, the ministerial priesthood, which means one is given the sacred power and authority to put his life at the service of the faithful. And priestly ministry are indeed essential for the life of the church. And there are three orders that we see in our Catholic faith. One, the bishop. Two, the priest. And three, the deacon. Kalimitan po, nakikita po natin itong kompleto. And the essential rite of the sacrament of holy orders for the three degrees consists on this, the imposition of the bishop's hands. Lagi po, mahalaga po yun. The moment the bishop forgets the imposition, hindi po na-ordinang pali. No, minsan po, totoo po ito, nakakalimot din po yung mga obispo at the moment of ordination, meron nangyayari talaga na nakakalimutan ng obispo yung imposition, no, or the laying on of hands. And I remember one occasion in one diocese, nakalimutan ng obispo yun, that in the evening, he has to call again those ordained during the day, that he has to make that imposition of the hands. Why? Because that's the matter that would really give the grace that this person is dedicated to what we call priesthood. So remember, baptism, the common priesthood, ordination, is what we call the ministerial priesthood. Alam niyo po, mahalaga po na tinitignan po natin that when we receive the gift of baptism and when we receive the gift of ordination, something changed in us, no? In you and in me. And this is what we call sacramental character. Alam niyo po ba yung hihiro yung animal, no? Yung parabagang binabagat muna yung steel sa apoy, at pagka mainit na ay itutusok ito, ilalapat ito sa pigi ng hayop, at babakat yung sa init doon, babakat yung tata. Palagay ko, kung ganun po ang paraan ng pagbigin niya, wala na po magbabigin niya kasi masakit po yun, ano? Pero the moment that we receive the gift of baptism, you receive also what we call the sacramental character. And what is that sacramental character? You become a child of God. We become children of God. At yung katotohanan po ngayon, hindi na maaalis. John Paul II, when he was invited to France, some of the young people, no, were asking the Pope to debaptize them, which means remove from us this gift of baptism. We do not want to be identified as Catholics, as baptized Catholics. But the Pope said that the moment we receive that gift, it is already there. It is already there. It is already imprinted in the soul of the person and it cannot be taken away. Kaya nga po, for example, meron nag-born again at nagpabinyag, does it mean that he lost what we call the membership of the Catholic faith? No. He remains a Catholic. Why? Because he received that baptism, that sacramental character as a Catholic person. That is why when a born again wanted to come back to the Catholic fold, hindi na ulit binibinigay po iyon. Ang ginagawa po ay is just as to renew his profession of faith. So, when you say sacramental character, it means you belong to somebody. No? Just like the theory of the animal, that animal belongs to a particular owner. I am the one who owns that animal. And so, every time the Lord looks at us, And since that character in you and me, God says, you belong to me. No? Pag-aari kita. Medyo mabilis ko ba dahil sa saan. So, yung ministerial priesthood po, it is at the service of the common priesthood. Remember that. I am emphasizing that kasi napakahalaga po nun. Service to the common priesthood. Why? Because priests are gift to you. And can we also become gifts to each other? Kung kami po ay biyaya po sa inyo, pwede po ba kayo din naman po ay maging biyaya din naman po sa amin? Bakit? Because we are chosen from among you. How many of you have attended ordination? How many of you have attended ordination? So kung titignan niyo po, right at the beginning of the rite of ordination, saan po nakaupo yung oordinan? No? Doon po, kasama ninyo. No? Kasama ninyo. Ano ibig sabihin po nun? That he is no different from you. I am no different from you. I am not different from you. I belong to you. I came from you. No? Galing po kami mga pari sa inyo. No? Hindi po yung parabagang hinihiwalay kami po sa inyo. But the moment that we receive the gift of ordination, binabalik po kami ng Diyos sa inyo. Hindi po pwedeng aalisin lamang, kundi matapos hanguin sa inyo, pigiin po sa inyo, binabalik po kami ng Diyos sa inyo. And that is why we are your ministers. We are at your service. Hindi po pwedeng naglilingkod po kami sa aming sarili. Now, siguro tatanong niyo po, what kind of priest do you want? Anong uri po ng pari ang gugustuhin niyo po? There is the story of the blind man and the elephant po. Yung aling na blind man, they were asked to describe the elephant. No? Ngayon, yung isa, hawak-hawak ay yung katawan ng elepante. At ang sabi niya, ay, ang elepante pala, it's like a wall. No? And then, yung isa naman po, hawak-hawak niya yung trunk ng elepante. At ang sabi niya, an elephant is like a spear. At para sa yung isa naman, hawak-hawak niya yung muso ng elepante. At ang sabi niya, an elephant is like a snake. And then, ang sabi naman isa, habang hawak-hawak niya yung paa ng elepante, it's like a tree. Yung isa naman, hawak-hawak yung tenga, it's like a fan. Yung isa naman, hawak-hawak yung buntot, ay, ang elephant pala is like a robe. Titingnan niyo po, isa lang ang hawak-hawak nila, pero iba't iba ang kanilang perspective about the elephant. Alam ko po na kayo po bilang mga laiko, bilang mga pinaglilingkuran namin, iba-iba din po ang pananaw niyo tungkol sa pari. Hindi po ba? How you wish that your priests are all holy? Hindi po ba? I believe you can demand that from us, your priests. No? Pero kung titignan nyo, on the human level, iba-iba po ang pari. Iba-iba ang character. Iba-iba ang behavior. Iba-iba ang attitude. Iba-iba yung pakikitungo sa inyo. Merong pari kinatutuan ninyo. Merong pari kinainisan ninyo. Merong pari, how you wish every day you will see. Bakit? Kasi binibigyan kayo ng pag-asa. Meron din naman pari, how you wish na hindi na siya makita. And how you wish umaalis na siya sa inyong parokya. No? Hindi po ba ganyan tayo? Iba-iba po ang pananaw po ng tao sa mga pari. Pero there is one truth. And what is that one truth? That He is still your priest. He is still your priest. We are still your priest. Alam niyo, one of the mysteries of our life as priests is, as we look at ourselves, tinitignan po namin araw-araw ang aming mga sarili. We continue to ask the question, why? I remember asking that question before my spiritual director, Father Albert Merskert. At ang sagot lang niya sa akin, why not? No? Why not? No? At wala na akong dinanong after that. No? Because that's true. Our life remains a mystery. Minsan na, matanda na, hanggang ngayon, tinatanong pa rin niya, bakit kaya pari ako? And siguro minsan nagtatanong din kayo, pag nakita niyo yung pari masungit, at kaya maging pari yun? No? Sa palagay ko, hindi nyo dapat tinatanong sa aming mga pari. Itanong nyo po sa Diyos. Yun po ang mensahe ng lahat. No? So, priests are all human beings. No? Patulad nyo din po, pag kinunod nyo, nasasaktan. Umiiyak din. Natutuwa din. Tumataba din. Nangangayalit din. Di po ba? Bakit? Kasi wala naman po tayong pinagkaiba. No? Wala naman po tayong pinagkaiba. We are all weak human beings. No? But God has chosen the weak and made them strong in bearing witness to Him. Remember that. The mystery of all is this. Yes, we are all weak human beings. I'm not just talking about myself. I am talking about ourselves. Lahat po tayo that we are all weak human beings and yet chosen by a good God. Di po ba? If even the apostles were weak, Peter denied Jesus, Judas betrayed Jesus, and yet Jesus said, it was not you who chose me, it was I who chose you. Ngayon po, siguro maganda, may isang priest you admire. Kahit ngayon lang po, ma-inspire po kayo ng konti. May isang priest you admire and inspire you to get closer to Jesus. And I invite you not only to pray for that priest, but even to thank God for the gift of that priest. Now, let us now allow St. John Mary Vianney reflect with us the meaning of the priesthood. There is a St. John Mary Vianney, according to some historians, according to his biographers, ang laging ang tingin sa kanya, St. John Mary Vianney has poor memory, poor intellect, kasi pumasok po siya as a lay vocation. And when his ordination was nearing, the rector confided to the bishop, he asked the bishop, "Bishop, there is someone who will be ordained priest, but he has poor memory. He is poor in everything. In fact, bumabagsak nga siya sa Latin during that time." Pero ang sabi ng bishop, "Is that seminarian good? Meron bang kabutihan ng loob yung taong iyon?" At ang sagot ng rector, "Yes, he is a good model. No? He is a good model." And look at the answer of the bishop. The bishop said, "Let him be ordained." And at the moment of ordination, it is said that the homily of the bishop says, "The church wants not only learned priests, hindi lamang po inyong kailangan matalinong pari, but even more, holy priests." But what is a priest according to St. John Mary Vianney? Very simple lang yung kanyang description of a priest. He said that a priest is a man who holds the place of God. Ibig sabihin nun, yung pari ay kumakatawan sa Diyos. He holds the place of God. Sabi ni St. John Mary Vianney, If I were to meet a priest and an angel, I should sagot, "Sik kayo po, pag nakakita po kayo ng anghel at pari, naglalakad, sino po yung bibigyan niyo muna ng paggalang o ng saludo? Yung anghel o yung pari?" No? Siguro, minsan papasa tayo, "Wow, the angel is somebody, something extraordinary." So, para sa akin, it's like seeing a vision. But look at St. John Mary Denis. Sabi niya, "If I were to meet a priest and an angel, I should salute a priest before the angel." And what's the reason? The angel is the friend of God. But the priest stands in the place of God. No? Which means when you see a priest, it is like coming in touch with God. It is like coming in touch with Jesus. No? Ako, minsan, habang ginagawa ko po ito, okay, hindi ko alam kung paano, no? Nadidisturb ako ngayon, no? Nakatingin kayo sa akin, hindi ko alam kung nakikita niyo yung Diyos sa akin, ano? Si St. Teresa of Avila used to kiss the ground where a priest had passed. Talagang habang naglalakad yung pari, hinahalikan niya yung ground na pinagdakara ng pari. Huwag niyo naman pong gagawin ito, no? Pasabihin ng pari sa inyo, padiw. So, if you look at the consecration, we can say that really that priest stands in the name of Jesus. No? Bakit? Kasi at the moment of consecration, hindi sinasabi ng pari na this is, or hindi niya sinasabi that this is the body of Jesus. Kundi sinasabi niya, "This is my body." It is not just referring to the body of Jesus, but even to His own body. No? Hindi lang sinasabi that this is the blood of Christ, the blood of Jesus, but this is the cup of my blood. No? So, we behold the power of the priest. The tongue of the priest takes God from a morsel of bread. Now, what is the role of a priest in your Christian life? What is the role of the priest in your Christian life? I would like to discuss with you two roles. The priest as a husband and the priest as a father. Most of the time, when we talk of priests, the first thing that comes to mind is the image of the good shepherd, di po ba? But I would like to make use of two models of looking at your priest. First, the priest is a husband. Bakit po? Kasi the moment that we become priests, kinakasal po kami hindi sa isang tao. Kinakasal po kami para po sa inyong lahat. Tandaan niyo po yun. No? Kaya huwag niyo pong sasabihin po na "He's my priest." No? Huwag niyo pong sasabihin niyo, "He's my priest." Kundi sabihin niyo, "He's our priest." No? Kasi pag sinimulan minsan, nag-Jesus yung pare. He's your priest. But He's our priest. Pari po namin siya. Hindi yung sasabihin, "Pari ko siya." No? Pag-aari po ang pari ng sambayan ng Kristiyano. Remember that. No? And si St. John Mary Vianney, kasi medyo hindi nga maganda yung kanyang yung parabang ang tingin sa kanya ay mababa, yung bishop put him in a very far parish, which is the parish of ours. Sabi ng bishop sa kanya, "There is little love of God in that parish, and you will be the one to put it there." Alam niyo, yung prayer ni John Mary Vianney is this, "Lord, grant me the conversion of my parish. I am willing to suffer whatever you wish for my entire life, for my parish." No? Which means,
inaangkin ng pari kayo, no? Inaangkin ng pari po kayo. And the other model is the priest as a father. You don't call a priest doctor. You do not call a priest mister. You do not call a priest just in his name, no? By simply using his name. But you call a priest father. Father So, Father Nino, no? Hindi yung sabihin, Hoy So, hindi yung pwede sabihin yan. Hoy Nino, hindi yung pwede sabihin yan. No? Because one time, I was so disturbed in one parish, no? When one time I visited a parish priest, and he prepared something. Ang tawag niya, ang tawag ng tao sa kanya, hindi ko na babanggitin, no? Kundi tinawag sa pangalan. Thought he was referring to the people around were referring to somebody, but they were calling their priest by simply his first name. No? And he said, sa mga tao, you know what? You are missing one point. You are missing one point. Your priest is your father. Ama yan ang tahanan ng parokya. You cannot just call your father at home na, oy, ener, kundi pagka narinig yung, di ba, sasampalin kayo ng tatay ninyo. Why? Kasi kawalan ng paggalang. Hindi naman kawalan ng paggalang, hindi mo kinikilala yung identity that is already part of the person of the priest. That by virtue of ordination, he becomes a father to all of you, to all of us. And what is the role of that father? Alam niyo, when St. John Mary Vianney was on his way to ours, medyo naligaw siya. And he met this little boy and he asked the boy, can you show me the way to ours? At dinala ng bata si St. John Mary Vianney to ours. Itong sabi ni St. John Mary Vianney, now that you have shown me the way to ours, now I will show you the way to heaven. My dear brothers and sisters, that is our role as fathers, to lead you to heaven. To lead you to heaven. Help us to show you heaven. Help us to show you heaven. So the priest is everything for you. The priest is not a priest for himself, but he is a priest for you. That is what the priest can do to your Christian life. Pero tanong natin, what is it that you can do for your priest? No. First is this. Let me tell you a story. Jesus met a man who was crying at the side of the road. Sabi ni Jesus sa kanya, what is wrong? No? When Jesus asked what was wrong, the man replied that he could not see. And so Jesus cured him. No? And then after a while, Jesus met another man who was crying. The man said, I cannot walk. And so Jesus cured him. Pero tingnan niyo, both of them were cured. But look at the third man. Jesus met a third man who was crying. And the man said, I am a priest. And look at what Jesus did. Jesus sat down and wept with the priest. So yung magtataka kayo, bakit yung dalawa? Tinulungan niya. Pero ito, iniyakan niya. Nakiiyak siya doon sa pari. Why? Because there is no distinction now between the Lord and the priest. Pope Benedict XVI tells us, a priest faces his master's same fate, but he also experiences Christ's joys. Ibig sabihin, halos wala pong pinagkaiba si Jesus ngayon at ang pari. But what are the five things you can do to help your priest? Five things. First, pray for your priest. We pray for you. Please pray for us also. Huwag niyo po kakalimutang magdasal po sa amin. Ngayon minsan, nakakatuwa po kayo, no? Maganda po yun na minsan i-invite niyo yung pari ninyo na kumain. No? Okay po yun, no? Pero huwag niyo naman po kakalimutan na ipagdasal niyo inyong pari. Huwag po kayo matutuwa pagka nakita niyo, wow, si Father nagdodobre na ang size. Eh kasi, pinapakain niyo yung pari. No? Nadodobre ang size ng pari sa kanyang katawan. Pero the question is, nadodobre din po ba yung espiritu ng pari sa kalooban? No? Baka you are just simply feeding your priest and you are happy na dati 130 pounds si Father, ngayon 180 pounds na si Father. Ang cute ni Father. Kaya hindi nyo alam, pinapatay nyo yung pari. No? Tandaan niyo po, sabi nga sa aming mga pari, minsan nagkakatuwaan po kami, meron po ba kayong narinig ang pari ay namatay sa dutong? No? Wala. Namatay sa heart attack, namatay sa diabetes, sa sobrang kabusugan. Alam po, tanda ito po ng pagmamahal niyo sa amin. Pero patabain niyo din po ang aming kaliwa. No? Approach your priest and say, Father, I am praying for you. We as a family prays for you. No? Pinagdadasal po namin. This is the first thing that you can do for your priest. Then second, participate and be active. No? What do I mean? Participate and be active. Do not just come to church. Do not just attend mass. Try to look at your talents. Try to look at your gifts. What is it that I can offer to help our priest? Kasi alam niyo, minsan, ang dami niyong expectations sa mga pare. Kinakailangan si Father ganito, kailangan si Father ganito, kaya alam niyo po, totoo lang, working for priests for many years, as the director of pari-pari, most of the priests in the archdiocese are already tired. Pagod na, and some of them are already asking for sabbatical. Why? Kasi halos wala nang maibigay. Kasi masyado nang yung energy ay nakuha. No? And so, the challenge for you is discover also how you can help your priest in his mission in this parish. Then, the next is, what's your expectations? Huwag niyo pong isipin magagawa lahat ng pari. Katulad nga na sinasabi sa inyo, isipin niyo ano din naman ang inyong magagawa. So, minsan, huwag lang po kayo nalapit sa pari at hihingahan niyo lang lahat ng problema niyo. No? Minsan, patawanin niyo naman po yung pari. No? Make him laugh. Make him happy. Pagka natulungan na kayo, go back to your priest and say, Father, thank you for helping us. Patabihin niyo din yung kalooban ng pari. Number four, believe the best. Alam niyo, sabi ko nga, marami pa yung makikitang negative about the priests. But there are also best things that you can tell about your priests. Now, minsan, pag nakita niyo, naku si Father, may kasamang iba. No? Ayan na, kumakalat na yan. Pero hindi natin tinitingnan, no? Kung ano yung kahulugan yun. No? Priests are also in need of companionship. But there is boundary in that companionship. No? So do not look at your priest in a negative way. But see also what is positive about your priest. Then number five, show your appreciation. If it is his birthday, if it is his ordination day, huwag yun ang pakainin, kundi give him a sense of affirmation. Give him encouragement. Thank your priest for giving his life to you and to the Lord. Remember his birthday and remember his anniversary of ordination. And so, priesthood is born from the Eucharist, and there is no Eucharist without the priesthood. Kung kailangan po natin si Jesus, kailangan niyo din po ng pari. No? We cannot do away with priest. Ito po yung challenge sa inyo. Siguro, kayo po, iba dito, may mga anak din. No? Encourage one of your sons to become priest. No? Kasi bakit? Kasi yung pari, hindi naman po usbong na biglang lumilitaw mo yan. No? Nagsisimula mo yan sa sinapupunan ng ina. No? And remember Pope Pius X, when he visited his 70-year-old mother after being ordained a bishop, the mother kissed her son's ring. Suddenly, she pointed out to her own simple silver wedding ring, saying, "Giuseppe, you will not be wearing that ring if I had not first worn mine." Ang ibig sabihin, every vocation to the priesthood comes from the heart of God, but it goes through the heart of a mother. So, my dear brothers and sisters, this is the challenge for us. This is the challenge for us. Siguro, as an end, let me leave with you four letters with four words. Letter P, letter E, letter A, and letter K. Letter P stands for pray. Pray for your priests. Letter E, encourage your priests. Letter A, affirm your priests. And letter K, know the beauty of the priesthood in your life. Magsitayin po tayo lahat. Let us all pray for the priest. The priesthood is the love of the heart of Jesus. And your response will be, Lord, gain your heart of the good shepherd. May all be. Lord, gain your heart of the good shepherd. For our Holy Father, Pope Benedict XVI, Lord, gain your heart of the good shepherd. For the successors of the apostles, Lord, give the heart of the good shepherd. For your bishops chosen by the Holy Spirit,
Lord, give the heart of the good shepherd.
For confessors and spiritual directors,
Lord, give the heart of the good shepherd.
For those who announce your word,
Lord, give the heart of the good shepherd.
For those who help lay apostolate, for those who work with the youth,
Lord, give them the heart of the good shepherd.
For those who work among the poor,
Lord, give them the heart of the good shepherd.
For those who care for the sick,
Lord, give them the heart of the good shepherd.
For poor priests,
Lord, give them the heart of the good shepherd.
For sick priests,
Lord, give them the heart of the good shepherd.
For the elderly priests,
Lord, give them the heart of the good shepherd.
For sad priests, for anxious and troubled priests, for the ridiculed and persecuted priests, for lukewarm priests, for the discouraged priests, for those who aspire to the priesthood, to all priests, let us pray in a special way for those priests through whom we have received the graces of God. We pray for the priest who baptized us, for the priest who absolved our sins, reconciling us with Jesus, with the Church. We pray for those priests in whose mass we have participated and assisted, and who have given us the body and blood of Jesus for our nourishment.
We pray for those priests that have shared God's word with us, and for those who have helped us and led us to Jesus. Divine Heart of Jesus, heart full of zeal for the glory of your Father, we pray for all your priests. May your Holy Spirit fill them with faith, zeal, and love. Amen. Mary, Mother of the Church and Mother of Priests. Saint John, Mary Yene. The Lord be with you.
And also
with you. God bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Maraming salamat po sa inyo.